from there in high risk. And the process is like we are doing, we are meeting once a week for 2 hours, and then we are doing a lot of drama at the beginning. And the filmmaker is always there as a part of. And from the story that they are telling us, in the middle of the 3 months, the filmmaker is coming in and is doing his job. And at the end, there is a script from the contact that the children were talking about. And we are doing film. We are shooting for 2 days a film that professional filmmakers coming from the outside. We have only 2 days to do all. It's a short film. It's like 15 minutes maximum. And a couple of months later, they're coming to a big cinema in Tel Aviv, the Cinematheque, and we have a premiere. So it's like a big event for them. This movie, we made it 2 years, 2 years ago, yeah, from into school in a city called Rehovot. And the team at this group was, there were all kinds of integration, all kinds of kids, some of them coming from a very economic, social economic, low social economic, and some of them are like better, but it was very integrated, this class. And the subject of this movie was a boy that he has a kind of difficulties to be social. He likes the stars, he likes to connect aliens, he's trying to connect some other creatures from the out, from the space. And suddenly he meets an alien that looks exactly like him. And the alien came to him because he wanted him to show him how it's going in his age, how people are connecting to each other, what is going on in school. And it's like he's doing a report, the alien is doing a report. And I'll show you a couple of minutes, Philip. I need you for the, you know, I need you next to me, please. my hand is not so gentle, like it. Yeah.
How much did
they
do?
A little bit.
Oh, okay.
You know, like little before.
More
before. Yeah. Yeah, maybe. This is the that is trying to connect the alien. Yeah, he's doing an experiment.
Something happened. It's a music project.
We are trying to do
I plan different things, but some materials are not working. So first we'll see just pictures, and then I'll show you some movies of the activity. So we mostly try to combine between music and between different arts. I can tell you that here we do a lot of drama, but in Israel drama it's our weak point, and now we after all this session I'm trying to put drama in the activities. So as I told you, we have our singing lessons, our choir lesson. So it depends who are the kids. For example, in this class we have kids with special needs, and they usually there are kids that they are taking Ritalin, you know,
Ritalin. Ritalin, yes.
And it's very difficult for them to concentrate. And after that, I'll show you some film with them. But one of the difficulty is that they can't stay on the chair. They always want to be running, or they are provocating each other. And when they are under the pills, let's say, it is possible. And these lessons really help them to enrich themselves and to build self-confidence. Usually they sing in front of their friends in the class, or in front of the other classes, or in front of the parents who are doing like events, and they can sing in front of the parents. But I told you about a big maybe not everybody know about it, but somebody already heard about it. It was a special event we did together with Moses Spain. We worked on a project that was about Ladino songs with a Jewish Ladino, which comes from Spain. So the kids from Spain studied certain songs, and the kids from Israel studied this song, and then we did a very nice concert with an orchestra, and it was a great event for the kids. They never sang with an orchestra. It was really a big thing for them. And after I talked with Laura, so I discovered...
I will explain it later as well. I will explain it.
Okay, so we have something in common thanks to this project. So she'll explain you later. We have our arts lesson. It can be art in the classes, the plastics arts, painting, sculpting, and we're going also out to the museums, like here you can see. And we have a collaboration with a museum of nowadays arts, modern art, where they have places to work in. And they want us to come, and we want them to have us. So it is a great situation. I remember Werner, he asked what can be done between museums or between orchestras. So I think that you can find certain organizations that it is very important to them to show to the public that they give also to the society. You just have to find these organizations. And for example, this this museum, it is very important to them to show that they give also to the society. And they invite us to see exhibition, and they give us their space, and they we are working with them on certain projects together. So it's a win-win situation. We're having it also with the Tel Aviv Museum. I told you about the scholarship program that we get from them now. In our activities, we are studying different instruments, playing instruments. Maybe some of you met Edgar, and Edgar is very good in teaching drums, keyboards, flute, recorders. I teach, well, in the past, right now I don't really, I'm mostly like a supervisor, let's say. But I taught also violin, and I had classes of violin. So this is the music part.
It's so sunny.
Yeah, it's sunny in Israel.
Sunny. Yeah.
Okay. Last year we began giving also martial arts lessons, is karate. I remember that when we were in Madrid, Pedro showed us a video of Yudi Menuchin, and Yudi Menuchin was talking also about about the good things that martial arts can give. So I got the idea from this video. I said, if you say it, so I have the right to bring also martial arts to our activities. And it works wonderful with our kids here. These kids are, you can see, they're not really Israeli, but are children of illegal workers that are coming to work in Israel. So we have we're working with quite many of these kids, and they are very enjoying the martial arts. But I'm always combine. I don't give them just martial arts. They have martial arts and they have music or martial arts and visual arts. It's always they have two subjects to get. Yeah, not one. Here also a class of kids from this circle, and here music for kids in the kindergarten. We begin with them in the kindergarten, and when they arrive to us, they don't even can't speak Hebrew, and it is very difficult for them to create connection with the environment, with the other friends, and especially if they had to enter school without language. And so they get a lot of support in the kindergarten, and with music and with songs they improve their language, and after that they continue to school and get all the other. Well, here it was. It is a film, but you can't see it now. We have dancing lessons for kids. It's Zumba here, and Zumba lessons, and they really like it. And here is the orchestra project that we have. Building a chamber orchestra at school. Kids are getting lessons in groups, small groups. We're talking about till six kids together in a lesson that get a violin lesson, cello, even the double bass, and we form a chamber orchestra. During the year we are doing many events. It can be a concert, it can be a going out to museums, to listen to concert, to exhibition, and different other things. I would like this is the lovely kid of Mercedes. We had a nice project between two choirs. One is our choir. For me it was very important to take advantage with music and to create a connection between low society children and high society children through the music. So I was in contact with a friend that is working in a kibbutz in a very rich place, yes, and they had their choir, and we had a choir from Bat Yam. It's a city near to Tel Aviv, which the kids never went out from the neighborhood. They don't know what it's a kibbutz. You know what's a kibbutz?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's a really lovely place. There's a lot of gardens and plants and everything is nice. And they were just in their neighborhood. They don't go out. They know just the school, their home, and all the area is not so nice. And it was important to me that if they'll see that through music they can go out, they can participate concerts, they can meet other interesting people, they can achieve things, it will make them a lot of it will motivate them to study and to want to arrive to achievements. And it was a really nice a connection. Our kids worked on certain songs, their kids work on same songs and also others. And then when the both choirs met themselves, we had like a workshop, like here together. Both so they had also time to meet each other. Then we organized a concert to the people from the kibbutz together. Then we organized a trip together with them so they could speak and they can know one each other. And I was really afraid in the beginning because I didn't know what kind of a connection they can find, because this key one is a poor one from a really, really basic home and with a lot of problems, and another has everything. And I thought to myself, what language, what common language will they find? And I worried a lot about it. But I was so glad to see that during the workshop, and when the workshop stopped, they began communicating, and they said, let's sing together here, just we three, and she plays the piano a bit, so she can play. And they like created small groups and began speaking, and then we went out to the nature, and it was really good contact, and it was beautiful. So I show you some pieces that they did from this concert. We should do it with the other program, no? Yeah, we should do it with this. Here we should open it. So I got a short game.
This is from the Jaffa Institute.
Yeah. So here the both choirs together. And if another one. Okay, I'll close because you know I want another song because it's connected to our monastery. So, this one, how do you do? You know what is the connection?
Look.
Sounds of music.
What is it?
The keys were hiding in the monastery.
The movie of Sounds of Music. With Julie Andrews. Back in the 80s.
Yeah.
They have twice a week.
Twice a week?
A lesson. Education.
This is choir. Yeah.
Something from the past, but it can show you about the activities of... this is another thing. Sorry. Here it's a mask workshop that I did with the kids. I wanted to do it too in here, but we had no time. So I find that the kids like to work with clay, and a good thing with clay that you can correct without using, you know, if you paint something and you are not really satisfied, so you take the machak,
eraser,
and begin, and then the kids are very, you know, they are disappointed, but here they can have something in mind, they can begin, they can change, and nobody see that something is wrong. And then also the subject, which is a mask, so everything is possible. There is no right or wrong, as we talked already. And so everything that they create can be done. One thing that I really like to do, that is in the beginning, we take papers, journal, and then we make like a ball. And then the clay we construct it on the ball of the paper, so it immediately gives them a three-dimensional. Space, and it's something that takes them to another dimension that usually they don't use. They usually stay in the two-dimensional, and very easily they are working on three-dimensional space, and it makes them feeling much stronger, much. You can see some of the works.
Prehistoric.
Everything is fine. Mm-hmm. ראית מה כתוב שם על זה? רעידה. אוקיי. Hey, is it fine? I can continue. I don't know how much time. You want,
we should have time for the perfection of dancing.
Yeah, okay, fine. Yes. So we saw enough, I think.
May I ask you something?
Yeah, sure.
I see many violins there. Who pay the instruments?
Yeah.
The project or?
Yeah. So we have a connection also. Werner asked what can be done. So we have a connection with the Philharmonic Orchestra, and. So we create this contact between us and between the orchestra, and they have a project that called Sulamot, Letters, which is teaching, building an orchestra at schools. And we said, okay, we want to join this project, we can find donors for it. So both sides said, okay, we'll do our efforts together. They have their donors, we have our donors, and we create like a project. We said, okay, we need for this project 20 violins, we need 7 cellos, we need 3 okay. double basses. Yes, and we, and then all the costs, how much we feel will be the cost of teachers and everything, and then we just we offered it to donors where we want to do this project, who willing to give money and like that, okay. And so
okay.
When we got the money, we bought everything, okay. And then after. After you have these instruments, they stay with you, yeah. So you can continue.
The instruments keep
the concert. The project is for 3 years with the same children. Yeah, they continue. They begin third grade, third, fourth, fifth, fourth. Mm-hmm. From the fourth to the sixth. They begin, and so the same kids continue
with the instrument for
3 years.
So and then
after the project is finished, usually when they arrive to the sixth grade, so usually they leave the school, they change school in Israel.
Okay.
So the project is finished, but at that time we are trying. If we have kids that really talent, and so we find for them places to continue. And another thing that it was very nice that during these music lessons, so parents couldn't believe that their kids will hold a violin, will play a violin, and they came to us. They asked where can they enroll the kids to private lessons, okay, that's it.
Thank you.